Hey guys, here's Dora from Ultimate Success Coaches. Hey, how are you doing? Now, I mentioned in another video already that of course I'm not sponsored regarding running shoes. New sponsor contract next year for me, first in my whole life, will come from Hammer regarding some products. So is it a sponsor contract? I would rather call an ambassador program, but I was super, super happy about, so that's another topic. Regarding running and running shoes, I'm not sponsored from any companies. I have never received a product to test this running shoe or so. So all the shoes you see here featured, it's from my own money. Which means, of course, there are so many new shoes on the market every year. It's not possible to test all the shoes. It's not possible to test even 10% of the shoes. Where I had to choose these top three training shoes, running training shoes this year, it was from a limited set of 7-8 shoes what I had purchased this year. It means I had also a list where I had as my wish list during the year, but for some reason those shoes were not selected in 2021. Now, to be completely honest, they are still on my list for maybe 2022, but let's see why. These are perfect running shoes as well, just on that same category for another reason I chose another one. I will be explaining for you. So the first one is a Max Cushion shoe, and that's the New Balance More version 3, which hit the market early 2021, and it just swept all out there. New Balance More version 1, version 2, we have not even heard about. Version 3 was just a hit. I haven't tried myself, so I have to believe the other testers out there. It's a really low drop, 4 mm drop, 33 in the heel and 29 mm in the forefoot. So that's quite unique, I would say, from a Max Cushion shoe. In the men's size, generally it's 310 grams, and the women's size is 250 grams, which is quite there at the daily shoe category even, really similar to my New Balance 1080 version 10, which I have from the New York Marathon. But the cushioning is absolutely different. It's fresh foam, of course, by both shoes, but this fresh foam makes New Balance more seems to be much more soft than the 1080 was. So I would be really interested in trying that one. Why I did not purchase this shoe, it's mainly because early this year also the Nike Invincible came to the market. That was around January as well, so it was really the same time that Nike Invincible and the New Balance More. I made the decision and that went for the Nike because that was a full ZoomX, really new technology. I was more interested on that one, so that's why a Nike really won for me. And I'm still using that Nike Invincible for my long runs, for my easy days, more the easy days, I would say, because I also don't have any long runs the past months, unfortunately. So that's why I did not purchase the more, but I'm still interested in. So maybe the next months, if I can really build up, which is my plan currently, just talked about with my last vlog as well, I really have to build up those kilometers, and the more can be a really, really great shoe for that. So maybe, who knows, year-end sales. I will also put all the links for some discounts in the description box below. This more was originally 150 euros and I see really some lower prices there. So maybe it will really go more in the sales around the 90-100 euros range, which is also more realistic, I really believe. The second shoe I also have on my list is the Adidas Boston 10. To be completely honest, the Boston 9 was already on my list last year, the Boston 10 also. But last year I purchased my first two Adidas shoes, that was the SR20 and also the Adios 5, which meant that the Boston 9 I skipped, and the same happened with the Boston 10. Though there is a big difference between the Boston 9 and Boston 10, it's really, really a new version with some energy rods from nylon as well, which means really the Boston is a training version of the Adios Pro, which I do have with the energy rod. So it's a different energy rod, but it's also built in. So this is really a huge, huge improvement, I believe, for the Boston 10. And also the Lightstrike Pro is in the Boston 10 combined with some EVA foam. So that's also really a training version of a racing shoe. That's that Boston 10. Of course, Boston, the name is also not without a reason. it used to be a marathon racing shoe. Would you use it as a marathon racing shoe? I don't think so. We have also those Alphaflies, those Vaporflies, those Adios Pros. The Boston 10, it must be a good shoe, but it's not really a marathon race day shoe. I would say really that it's for those tempo trainings, those intervals, that can be a really great shoe for. It has also 7.5 millimeters of drop, so it's also different, of course, from the New Balance More. 39 millimeter in the heel, quite high, and 31.5 in the forefoot. I would say if I have to choose a competitor for this shoe from my own rotation currently, that's the Asics Nusa. I don't say, of course, that it's the same build or so, but for me it's a very similar use case. That's why I purchased the Asics Nusa, because of course in my heart I'm still a triathlete. I am a triathlete, and that Asics Nusa I have connections with, so that's why I was super happy that there is a new version for the Nusa, and that's why I purchased it. And I didn't really have those kilometers in that Nusa. I don't even have a full review yet. So for the coming months, I think I will also be using the Nusa more. So that's why I didn't purchase the Boston 10, but it's also on sales. Currently, you can really purchase it. Original price was 150 euro, and now you can easily see around 110 euros. Maybe in January, February, it will go even below the 100 euros. That would be my expectation. So let's see how that Boston 10 will just go there. The third shoe in this category, what I did not purchase but was long on my wishlist, and this one was even the wishlist on my fiancé's for Black Friday, but I didn't see really any huge Black Friday deals, and that's the Asics Nova Blast version 2. Of course, it's the version 1 because I have only the version 1. And why I did not purchase the version 2 is that I felt that I really love this shoe, and there are some updates on the version 2, but not so much that would be worse for me. And also, though I used this shoe a lot last winter, it can still get 300-500 kilometers, I would say 500 kilometers at least, because it's just a massive build. I love the cushioning, and you can hardly see after 200 kilometers any wear on this, also the outsole. So that's why I decided I will not purchase it. There are some updates, and those updates are definitely on the upper, some smoother upper there, and also the stack height in the heel is 2 millimeters less, so they really got that more ground feel in the shoe. They put a wider outsole out there for more stability. Yeah, as mentioned, I didn't really need it, but I can absolutely understand if some people were feeling some stability challenges there. So that's why, though I'm interested in the second version, I'm not really planning to purchase this second version as of now, and even not if it would be in the sales. The original price is 140 euros for the version 2 of the Nova Blast, and the past weeks I have seen it around 90-95 euros here in Europe, so it means it's also just going down. By the way, these prices are really crazy. I remember a few 2-3 years ago, really, 60-70 euros you could purchase a general training shoe for running from a good company, a good shoe on a bit of sales. Two out of these three shoes are 150 bucks, and this is 140. Even the Nike Invincible 180, yeah, so we can say that in average it's 150 euros. That's a lot of money. So I can recommend check out the sales the coming weeks. January, February will definitely come with some good sales. I will let you know also maybe some best grabs in January. So these were the issues though I really liked in 2021 based on the reviews and based on the features I did not purchase. Did you have also some in this category? I would be super interested in drop in your comment box below. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to the channel. Hey, take care, be healthy, be safe out there. See you in the next video. Bye.